Hello, my name is Dr. KOKOU H. I'm from Ghana, formerly known as Gold Coast because we have a lot of gold. I came here in Tata Memorial Hospital as part of fellowship with Merck Oncology Program. In terms of challenges in cancer care in my country, I would just like to focus on pediatrics because this is where my area is. I know in other areas a lot of things are being done, but in pediatrics we need a lot of support. So let me start this way. It starts from patient knowing about cancer or parent knowing about cancer. The awareness in my country is low, just like other neighboring countries. So that explains why patients come to us very late. That's the first thing. So they come late, and so they come in advanced stage. This informs also how badly they are going to do at the end of the day. So the second thing is that the doctors at the peripheries also knowing or being able to diagnose cancer in children, because there's this notion that how can children also get cancer? So that also delays patients coming to us. So we need to improve the knowledge of doctors as well in the peripheries. Now when it comes to us, we have challenges with diagnosis. We can diagnose that this is cancer, but in these days in time, we can just say this is cancer, let's say leukemia, and that's all. You need to go to the bottom of the type of leukemia that it is. That's what we call risk stratification. Because nowadays, if you can type the cancer very well, you will know the better care that you can give for better outcome. In developed countries now, more than 80% of children with cancer are surviving, as compared to barely 20% in our countries. Even though we are improving, we are still far away from what is being done elsewhere. So the other thing now is access to medications, because medications are very expensive. Then we need some generics that we don't have, or get patients having, because low socioeconomic status, making it hard for patients and parents to afford the medications that are being given. One big problem we have also is supportive care, because it's been shown, like our data have shown, that a lot of our patients are dying, not necessarily from the cancer, but from other manifestation or other complication that comes as a result of the cancer. Let's say infection, or patient needing blood, or needing platelet. Even though we have all those measures or care to give, we don't have enough, or we don't have sophisticated ones to give to our patients. So that's also our challenges. And then at the end of the day, how do we follow them up? And how do we conduct robust research to find out whether what we are doing it right or not? A lot of things have been done in my country. My country has been one of the earliest countries that started cancer care in the 60s, even when chemotherapy has been discovered. But still, we have a lot of challenges. Our challenges have even made greater because at least more than 10% of patients who come to us come from neighboring countries, which means that if we can improve cancer care in my country, it will benefit neighboring countries as well. And first of all, let me say that we have very few pediatric oncologists in my country. Currently, we have two. Merck had trained one of my colleagues earlier, and we also have two other colleagues who are just like me, becoming a pediatric oncologist. If we put that together, maybe in the next 2-3 years, we will have about 5 pediatric oncologists, which is really far away of what we are supposed to be having, because currently we have about 250 children annually that are newly diagnosed with cancer in my country. Even that number is far away from what we are supposed to be having, because per our statistic, we are supposed to have more than 1,000 new cases of cancer registered in my country, but currently we are having only 250 and 2 pediatric oncologists, and in the future 5 pediatric oncologists is far away. So we need more hands, we need more pediatric oncologists to be able to do that work. And then we have 38% of children in my country are less than 15 years. So we have a huge percentage of children in my country. For 5 pediatric oncologists, just imagine how it's going to be. So training more pediatric oncologists is very important, and I think this program came at the right time. That's the first thing. So the second thing is that the program is happening at Tata Memorial Hospital. We know that Tata Memorial Hospital is one of the biggest or the prime hospitals in South Asia, not only in India, but in South Asia. And then what we came to see here is that we have survivors that are closer to what is being done in Western countries. So it's just like a fortunate coincidence that Merck decided that we have to come to Tata Memorial Hospital. So it is really important that we increase our numbers. It is really important that we learn the best practices in pediatric childhood cancer management that we can replicate in our countries. How is it going to benefit us? As I said, first, increasing the numbers. Second, increasing the knowledge. And a third is also setting up the systems that are going to be helpful to us in terms of cancer management. Because it's one thing to have the knowledge, another thing to have the means or the medications or the logistics to diagnose cancer. But how do you put up this whole system that are going to be helpful to you to have a good team for pediatric cancer management? I've learned some of those things here in Tata Memorial Hospital, where they also started little, they struggled a lot, and they set up support group system. This bringing on NGOs together, reorganizing the nurses who are dedicated to the care of children with cancer, and have these dedicated doctors and consultants and residents who are just breaking their back day and night. And sometimes I just ask myself if they have a life, but it's just for the good of the children who have cancers. And I told myself, well, maybe my life is worth thousands of children who are saved with cancer. So if I can sacrifice whatever is my comfort to those children, I'll really do it. My expectation coming here, before coming, I said I want to know how to be confident in managing childhood cancer. And the second thing is I want to understand what it takes in terms of system improvement in setting up a good team of people who can manage childhood cancer. So, but when I came here, I think I got more than what I'm expecting. And actually, I'm a bit disappointed in myself because I think the time is too short. Because there's so much to learn. And I came to understand that childhood cancer is like a lifelong learning process. There's no way you ever finish learning, because every day new things are being discovered. Every day the frontiers of what can be done for those children just being moved. New possibilities are coming. Old days, there are certain medications you can give, expect some smaller number of patients being cured. Here, you can even use lesser toxic medications and still expect a higher outcome. So it's not like 1 year may not suffice, even 2 years may not, but I understood that process. And I wish I've come here earlier. I wish I stayed longer, but again, there's supposed to be, you know, a limit to how much you can learn from here. And then going back home, I just expect that. I still have this support with me as I'm implementing whatever I learned here. So my expectations have been met beyond what I came with. And apart from the knowledge I got in terms of the skills and the management of childhood cancer, I also got to be mentored in research, where my mentors have taken me through some basic things in paper research conduction and paper writing. So I'm really grateful to those opportunities, and I know that when I go back, definitely I'm going to implement them. And then the network, the networking opportunity that I have here are also going to be helpful when I go back home. So really, it's worth coming, and I'm grateful for that. Being here at Tata is just like reading through textbooks. And if you want to see cases of cancers here, I've seen them all that you can describe in a casebook. Because here you have more than 2,000 new cases, cancer cases in children being diagnosed. And I've been here for almost 1 year. So I can say confident I've seen them all. I may not know very well how to manage all of them, but I've seen them all. And then they go beyond what I could see in my country, because here we have all the possibilities to diagnose the cancers and then the different subtypes, which we cannot do currently, and we hope to do in the future. But at Tata, I'm able to do that. So my rotation at Tata I went through pediatric solid tumors and then pediatric hematolymphoid. And also, I rotated through general benign hematology and then immunology as well. There's work on the ward that actually bring all the cases, solid tumors, hematolymphoid together. And there's these beautiful opportunities also during which all the cases get to be discussed by a multidisciplinary team. These are really a good learning process, got good learning opportunities where everybody, consultant and resident alike from the pediatric department and other department get to contribute their experience and their knowledge towards the management of one particular case. It's really interesting because it builds your confidence and at the same time it exposes you to the mind of or the point of view of other different specialists who sees the cancer, this particular case, differently. And there's also the research aspect of it, as I mentioned earlier, where we have to analyze data from a ongoing clinical trial and present it at a conference. And then at the same time, we try to implement a quality improvement program, and we presented it at the department, and this has taken off. So really, the opportunities here are really tremendous, and I wish again that I had more time to perfect my hand, but I think whatever I got now, it's solid enough to build on it. So it's been a really great opportunity being here at Tata Memorial Hospital. Anytime I mention to my colleagues who are elsewhere around the world, they just say, "Wow, you're at Tata." Even when I mention to my friends from India that I'm currently in Tata, I can just see the amazement they have, and then this beautiful surprise that they have on their face. It tells me anytime I share this with them that how fortunate I am to be here at Tata Memorial Hospital. And as I said earlier, a lot of beautiful things have been done here in terms of patient management, diagnosis, patient support. I mean, it's just so amazing. And it's something I am doing a lot with little. You just see few numbers of people who are so dedicated towards one goal, for patients to be fine. And they're just doing their work so beautifully. And I cannot just be grateful enough for that opportunity. I really like it. So I want to thank Merck Foundation for this beautiful and wonderful opportunity. I never have thought of a better one than this. Like, first, give me the opportunity to train in pediatric oncology as part of my main fellowship program, and also being here in Tata Memorial Hospitals, where they've tried a lot of things And then they've come a long way to improve cancer care, to set up this system that works for many children, whether they have money or not. It's just so amazing that they give this level of care to children and their parents who even don't have money. I'm so grateful for that. I'm so grateful that for all the other things that have been done in the background that we are not aware of, because I don't think it's so easy to coordinate many people from different countries coming to one country together and learning here and then go back to their countries. And then I'm sure that they have more packages in their planning, in terms, because I don't believe that we can just live here and then that's it. Because there's supposed to be a long-term support, and I'm thanking them in advance for those ones as well. Really, I'm happy for the opportunity I got, and I thank Merck a lot and Merck Foundation a lot for that.